The next day, Betsy was no longer moving. The long-awaited buzzard flew over and began to tear at Betsy's body. But the next moment, Betsy grabbed the vulture with all her strength. No matter how hard it struggled, Betsy wouldn't let go and finally managed to break his neck. Like a true predator, Betsy began to feed on the hard-won energy. Now Betsy finally understood that the only way to survive was to rely on herself. Soon Betsy had the strength to start climbing down the safety rope. After reaching the bottom, she took off the safety buckle like Kim did before and jumped onto the beacon. The vulture that was gnawing on Kim's body was scared away by Betsy's powerful aura. After being stared at by Betsy, Betsy then took out her cell phone and sent a message to her father, then took off Kim's shoes and put the phone in. Betsy said sorry to Kim, then shoved the shoe into the lacerated wound on Kim's abdomen. Finally, she pushed her down the tower. This time, the phone had a cushion of Kim's body. The father finally received the message and drove to the TV tower in a hurry. With the help of the police, Betsy was finally rescued.